Hello there, it's Haley with the Armageddon Report. We have our first hurricane in the Atlantic of the season, Hurricane Chris. And what's funny about that to me is that I believe as the first advisory when Hurricane Chris was just Tropical Storm Chris, they were actually saying that now Hurricane Chris was going to turn into like a post-remnant low or whatever within, you know, just a day or so. So Chris has, you know, strengthened beyond all expectations. However, Chris is apparently at the peak of, well, at least as of right now, the predicted speed. So, hurricane status here, and then tropical storm strength, all the rest of the places. And of course, let's zoom out a bit to give some context. Hurricane Chris is nowhere near land, and at least as of right now, not expected to hit land. And I'll show you one more thing. Here's cyclogram.com, of course. Oh, yes, and the Eastern Pacific, after being as high as 80 and 90% with their risk, is back down to absolutely nothing. Oh, yes, and this that started out as just a 10% blob of probability is now up to 50%. Right, this is what I was going to show you. This is hidden at the moment because it's not quite done, is it? But, and it would be more impressive if there was still the yellow thing, but I finally have my consolidated Outlook map where you can look at both outlooks on either side of the whichever ocean you're interested in on one map. But of course, there's nothing in the Eastern Pacific to look at right now. And of course, it would be quite helpful, wouldn't it, if Hurricane Chris were actually on this map. So yes, Eastern Pacific, nothing really going on. Atlantic, now this one would be affecting land, so we'll keep an eye on that, but really the National Hurricane Center will keep an eye on that. But let's move on to here, where we can see Philadelphia still having the excessive heat warning, so that really sucks. Heat advisory, and then California and Arizona has lost its, you know, heat-related advisory, so it's all about the East Coast now with the heat advisories and the excessive heat warnings. Red flag warnings is the fire-related thing going on for Utah and Nevada and some of Colorado. Colorado, last time I checked, was having a big wildfire, but I wasn't quite up to date on that. So hopefully that, you know, that's not good, obviously. Flood conditions still up here. Flood warnings, in fact. And apparently a civil emergency somewhere. That would probably be for a child abduction. So obviously, if you're in the Minnesota area, you should stop by your local National Weather Service office and read that. Right, so severe thunderstorm weather today, quite tame. So there's not even a slight risk on the map, is there? There's 5% chance of winds and hail. So in order to find out where they are, we go on over to here to see the jelly bean in New Mexico and Texas, and then a 5% up here. And then, for some reason, a tiny, thin, narrow 5% there. And with the hail, we lose the threat there, but we retain the 5% there. And tornado-wise today, less than 2% all areas. However, tomorrow, South Dakota, maybe Montana, little bit of Wyoming, and Nebraska. So South Dakota and Nebraska, basically. And then Pennsylvania, New York, we've got a whole bunch of states. West Virginia, maybe Virginia. Going on with a slight risk out on the coast. So if you see that, you can see that a lot more of the coast is affected by 5%, and then a lot more of the northern states are affected by 5% up here. Day after tomorrow, the confusing thing again with no thunderstorm areas forecast, so we flip on over to the probability map and find out it's basically potato state and Montana with the 5%. Day after tomorrow, day four, whatever that be, after the day after. Yes, after the day, after tomorrow, it's day four or something. Predictability too low. So there is severe thunderstorms on the horizon in days 4 through 8. But timing and or location is not yet certain enough for the Storm Prediction Center to put something on the map. So basically, yesterday, quite tame. Who knows what's going on? This is probably just a general, here's thunderstorm area, thunderstorm area. Thunderstorm area, one of those, and maybe it's that. I have no idea. It's very confusing, isn't it? Anyway, so here, any of these areas, you should pay attention because that's a whole of 5%. That's huge when it's compared to 0%, of course. And yes, of course, forgot to say, WikiWix is WikiWix.com. Cyclocaine is slowly becoming more and more relevant, you know, but really you should be stopping by the National Hurricane Center instead if you're interested in that kind of stuff. And of course, obviously, if this turns into something, the next thing I'll need to work on is land hazards and passing those. So like, for instance, Chris, no hazards affecting land, that, you know. So, and yes, if you'd like to watch these screencasts on a website instead of YouTube for some reason, you go to severeweathertv.com. If you can't spell that, I can't spell it for you because it's far too many letters. .com. Right, so that's it for now. Enjoy yourself, and of course, if you're in this area tomorrow, you should pay attention tomorrow. And yeah, take it easy.